So one of the neat things about willows is when you cut them down, they don't die. They live on in their root ball. So when we harvest the willows, it's really just like mowing a giant woody lawn. And so what we have here is a system that self-renews and allows us to keep harvesting it and keep feeding it and keep improving the soils at the same time. My name's John Lavery. I'm a senior scientist and business development manager with SYLVIS Environmental. Today we are at Paintearth Mine, which is the home of the Biosalix project. SYLVIS is a company that was founded on the premise that our wastes are too good to waste. We research, recommend, and implement the beneficial use of residuals like municipal biosolids, biomass, ash, food scraps, composts, and find ways to reintegrate those into the environment for the benefit of society.
Here's how the mine land is reclaimed. In partnership with EPCOR, Westmoreland Coal Company, Bionera, and the Canadian Forest Services and Natural Resources Canada, the Biosalix project will take biosolids and use them to amend the existing topsoil. Their goal is to establish a fast-growing willow wood biomass crop on the reclaimed mine land. Within 2 to 3 years, that woody biomass can be used as a feedstock for clean energy, reclamation, or bioproduct development.
The one thing that is always going to keep happening in that land base is carbon is going to keep sequestering itself in the soils. It's going to keep sequestering itself in the woody biomass. By planting the willows, you've started the renewable process. You've started closing that loop. We're very interested in a number of neat opportunities for the willows, and we want to make sure that we're making the best possible decisions to support the mining company, Westmoreland, and the best possible decisions to support EPCOR, the biosolids generator, to make sure that this project has decades and potentially generations of renewable and sustainable opportunity into its future. The Biosalix project has received over $2.1 million from ERA.